Okay, good afternoon. My story will be a rather practical story of how Bekaert has learned to deal with domain names. Okay, about the agenda, the contents. First of all, a short profile of Bekaert to allow you to judge whether or not you should adopt the same policy. Then two, because I'm in charge of industrial property, a short introduction of industrial property at Bekaert, and this is the correct platform to go to domain names. Then three, a little bit some legal issues about properties of trademarks on the one hand and properties of domain names on the other hand, and you will see that they are created to have conflicts between each other. Then four, how Bekaert was dealing with domain names before 2008, and this was not the good example, I can tell you. Then thereafter, we have introduced the domain name policy, and I would like to highlight a little bit of the features of that policy. And then the sixth chapter is about how we are now approaching and using the trademark clearinghouse. Bekaert profile, we are an international business. It's mainly business to business, so not business to customer activity, which is good. Global manufacturing platform, about 27,000 employees. Okay, so worldwide, and our strategy is in fact a strategy of obtaining sustainable, profitable growth in two ways, namely by having the leadership both with respect to technology and with respect to markets. In two technology domains, namely steel wire transformation and coatings on steel wires, advanced coatings on steel wires. Okay, these are a little bit illustrations of our core technical competences, but I will skip that. These are illustrations of a number of products that we have. Maybe to illustrate here one of them, I will come back on that, is our Dramix fiber for concrete reinforcement, because I can give you some examples of trademark and domain name issues in that respect. Okay. Global presence, so the offices are red balls and the plants are blue balls. Regarding technology, we spent last year almost 70 million in-house R&D. We have a central R&D center in Deerlijk, close to Zwevegem. And we have also an almost the same size R&D center in China, in Jiangyin. Okay, so this was a short introduction of the Bekaert profile. Now, with respect to industrial property, we have a central IP department in Belgium, and we are located at the Technology Center. And we have another IP department in China, also located at the Asian R&D Center. At the IP department, we deal with patents, but not only with patents, also with trademarks, designs, trade secrets, copyrights. We review all IP clauses and agreements. We are not lawyers, but we work closely together with our legal department. And since 2008, we also deal with domain names. The general policy that we like to follow with respect to IP titles is that of central ownership. And the ownership is in Belgium, is the mother company NV Bekaert SE. Okay, a little bit about the size of our portfolio. So for patents, we have about 330 patent families, 1,600 patent applications and patents. Designs, this is limited, 24 design families, 125 design registrations. Trademarks, 303 trademarks or trademark names, and 2,463 trademark registrations. Domain names, this is increasing, and we have more than 200 domain names. Okay, a little bit about trademarks, because the story about trademarks is a little bit the same as we will have later on with domain names. Namely, before every business unit, every product manager launching a new product on the market could select a new name for that. And after having selected a new name and obtained the registration for a trademark, he thought that he had conquered the market. But this has led in a number of cases to loss of value. If I give you the example of the Dramex fiber for concrete reinforcement, in the building industry, the name Dramex is well known, but a lot of people, a lot of customers did not know that Dramex belonged to Bekaert. So this was in fact an opportunity that we lost to create value, and to create value on the Bekaert, on the global name. And in the beginning of the years 2000, we introduced the policy to build more upon the value of the Bekaert name. And with respect to existing trademarks, we have gone through the list, and only those which were valuable in the market, we have kept them. With respect to new trademarks, these are from now on, or from the start of that new procedure, they are highly discouraged, and they have to go through a number of filters. So first of all, they have to obtain the green light by the communication department. Then secondly, they have to obtain a positive advice by industrial property department, whether or not there are conflicting rights, yes or no. And then finally, it's the top management, so the Bekaert Group executive, which is going to decide whether or not the trademarks will be filed, the new trademarks. Also with respect to branding, the branding policy has also been centralized and has become global and also imposed upon every business unit. The individual trademarks must be used from now on together with the Bekaert name. Okay. With respect to domain names, if you look a little bit at the features, the legal features of a trademark, so there is a registration procedure where prior arts are checked for any conflicting. A trademark has local value. So there is almost no value attached to a trademark outside the territory where it has been registered. And except for notorious or well-known trademarks, the trademark protection is limited to a particular subgroup of products or services. Put next to that, in fact, the features of a domain name. They are almost always in conflict and just the opposite. So particularly in the beginning, the start of domain names, it was a system of first come, first served, and there was no check at all on prior arts in the beginning. The domain name is an internet address, so in principle, there are no borders there. And then in its primary original conception, no limitation to products or services are attached from the origin to a domain name. So it is not a surprise that with the increasing importance of domain names, a lot of conflicts have arisen between, on the one hand, trademark holders, and on the other hand, the owners of domain names. How has Bekaert approached the domain names? Well, I must admit, and if I'm honest, there was no original approach, or no structured approach. It was an ad hoc approach. There was no or a limit link with trademarks, and everything was decentralized. So a product manager could decide to apply for a domain name, for example, bigrosie.com, because the name of his product was Bigrosie. He could perfectly arrange together in his department to have a separate website without a link to the central website. So this was perfectly possible. Also, inside the department, we were a little bit struggling where to organize and where should the domain names belong. Should it be legal department? Should it be the communication department, or must it be IT, because there is a strong link with IT? Or is it the IP department? Or should we leave everything to marketing and sales organization? We did not know. And now and then, we have met difficulties to obtain some domain names. For example, we had difficulties to obtain the domain name Beckard.cn because a free rider had applied for it. And despite the fact that we have local people there, we were not able to convince him to hand over that trade name at a decent price. It has taken us quite a lot of time. Another example was that in Poland, there was a previous customer who had the domain name Beckard.pl. He was a previous customer, a customer of the steel fences of Beckard. But in 2005, Beckard decided to divest the business of the fences, and he was no longer a customer. But he wanted to continue to make use of the value of the Beckard name. We went to court to attack him for trademark infringement. We were sure that we would prevail, and we have prevailed, but the time it has taken us and also the money it has taken us was quite considerable. And between the court case, well, of a court case, particularly then in Poland, you're never sure about the outcome. Although we were pretty sure, but 100% sure, you never know. So I think the time was there to do it in another way, after having met some accidents and incidents. I illustrate here a quote of Jeremy McGovern, which talks about multiplicity of websites. And in fact, what an organization should do is try to centralize and to use one single website. Okay, now you are a little bit at the topic that where I wanted to come, domain name policy. What were the objectives of that domain name policy? In fact, we introduced the domain name policy after having hired an e-communication manager who was fully aware of the power of the website and who wanted to change a number of things inside Beckard. He took contact with the legal department, took contact with the IP department, and also with the IT department. And the objectives of that domain name policy was to support a global uniform online presence, avoiding multiple websites which dissipate the power of the internet and the company. One of the other objectives was also to have a centralized domain name ownership. So not the business units, not the joint ventures, but a central group service. Also, the management of the domain names had to be centralized. Before 2008, we were not able to pull out a list or to print a list with the domain names at Beckard. We were not able to do so. It was also an objective to become more efficient and also to become consistent with the global brand policy and also with the policy with respect to trademarks. That was another objective. Beckard.com has then been reinforced as the global gateway to the Beckard world. It's the reference website for Beckard worldwide. And all the various units of the Beckard Group are obliged or imposed to identify themselves with one global corporate website. Beckard.com is the overall entry point. The list of existing domain names, it has taken some difficulties to collect all names, and then they have been divided into three categories: the must-haves, the nice-to-haves, and the garbage. And next to that, we have also drafted a list of must-have domain names and have given that list to register.be, who keeps an eye on it. And once they become available, we get a communication or an email so that we have the opportunity to buy them. Okay. Some other points out of that domain name policy are it's central funded. So no funding by the separate business units. The group service, the central group service is funding. There is a central request procedure similar with that to new trademarks. And both corporate communication and IP department have an advice on that. Before a business unit or a product manager is able to launch or to buy a new domain name. And except for the central domain name, so Beckart.com, the domain names only function as a referrer to the live website. With respect to the management of portfolio of domain names, the focus is on the Beckart brand, the Beckart name. There we have quite some extensions. And on some key product brands, for example, Dramex that I have already mentioned, which is the trademark for our fiber for concrete reinforcement, and also Motto, which is a brand for barbed wire, which is quite important in Latin America. We also try to have some domain names on descriptions which are relevant to the Beckart business, for example, tirecord.eu. The implementation of that management of domain names have been given in the hands of register.be. And inside the IP department, we keep a mirror database so that at every time we are able to pull out the list and print out the list and inform the various business units. And also to allow them to decide whether or not we will maintain them, yes or no. With respect to the Beckart clearinghouse, we have not applied for a generic top-level .Beckart. This is not our focus, this is not our business. We have filed following trademarks with the help of register.be in the trademark clearinghouse, namely the name Beckart, Dramex and Motto. Despite the fact that we have more than 200 trademarks, different trademarks, we made a selection because these are the most important ones. For each extension, we will decide case by case whether or not we will register. When preparing here for this presentation, I was interviewed by a journalist and he was asking whether or not Beckart would register or go for the dot Vlaanderen. Honestly, I don't know, but I don't think so. Although we are proud that we still have the headquarters of an international company in Flanders, we are proud about that, but we are an international company, and I don't think there will be added value for our company to register and to go for Beckart.Vlaanderen. That was a little bit my reply to that. So you should align what you register with, in fact, with your business. And not because of some other reasons. Okay, thank you very much. Are there questions? Well, we have not yet received the request up to now, since the launching of the domain name policy. But if I compare it a little bit with the procedure for trademarks, some are accepted, some are not accepted. But you must come up with a reason why a new domain name is of some value for the business. And if that reason is well motivated, I think it will be accepted.
Do you have an eye on the importance of some launches in other countries? Maybe launching from Brazil would be really important, and you in Europe, you don't have any idea of the importance.
Well, it must be motivated by the people who requested it. and they should have a reason to do so. And if that is well motivated, I think it will be accepted because the group business executive, they perfectly know what is happening in Brazil. The communication department as well, we have contacts there, so we don't look only at Europe. So, yeah. We are quite liberal in accepting extensions for China, for example. Because we are afraid there of more infringement, more free riders trying to get some money from us with all types of registrations, so that there we are more liberal. Yeah. Does that answer your question? Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yes, yeah. I don't know by heart, but if I compare it with the budget for trademarks, it's much, much lower. But I don't know by heart. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I saw you have one generic domain under Tire Court. How do you decide to manage those? Because to say local markets, like you might want to be in Spanish or Chinese, are they aware or read that you have this one? Do you pick it as one of the main keywords for Getter? Or do you wait for them to process a request saying for SEO purposes, it would be good to own this market with our main keyword in the local language?
I think, for example, for Spain, we will not go for a separate domain name, tirecourt.es for Spain, but if that would become available for China or for United States, I think we would be a candidate to go for that. But there are quite some other descriptive domain names that we would like to have, but these are much too expensive. For example, wire or steel wire, this is, yeah.
Relative. If you turn into a successful site that generates extra sales, the business case would be quite easy. So it's very hard to say they are too expensive. Maybe spending $100,000 over 10 years is worth $10,000 a year in extra money. I'm trying to understand how you assess the value of those generic domains.
Well, your B2B, for example, tirecourt.eu, Neem Beckhardt is well known with the four major tire manufacturers in the world. And whether or not we have such a domain name or not, will not make the difference.
That's an argument against registering.
Yes, yes. This is why we only went for the cheaper ones, which are available.
It's a very mixed message. Yeah. Trying to find the reason.
Yeah.
But still.
Don't think we are that far yet, and whether or not we will come that far, I'm not sure. No, that's.
Thanks for the answer.
Yeah. This is what we need for the time being, Beckhardt.com. But what will bring the future, I don't know. But if someone else would have .steelwire, I think we would apply for the second level than Beckhardt.steelwire. That for sure. But to go for .steelwire, I don't think so. Yeah. Okay. Any other questions? Thank you very much. Yeah.